Happening right now, local leaders are discussing the state of downtown Pittsburgh.
Channel 11's Tricia Pittman got a look at the progress report earlier today and shows things are definitely looking up.
Pittsburgh has such a great quality of life, and we have received acknowledgement from that from just about every source imaginable. And so that's continuing to draw more folks in.
Recent projects have invested over $2 billion into the greater downtown area, bringing in a resurgence of workers and residents. In addition to new high-rises, existing office buildings are seeing low vacancy rates. At the end of 2012, the Central Business District saw an occupancy rate of 92.9%. Over 126,000 people now work downtown, and six Fortune 500 companies call our city home. Desirable apartment, loft, and condo space has brought in approximately 1,000 new residents in the past 2 years, with 95.9% of all available residential space occupied.
We have such great institutions in Pittsburgh, from our medical institutions to our universities, really attracting more younger folks into the city, and that's playing off. These people want to live in a walkable community. They want to be able to take mass transit.
And they have. Mass transit brought more people into the city during 2012 than it did during the past two previous years, despite increased fares and decreased routes. T ridership has seen the largest increase.
Despite all the progress, there's still vacancies, and people who work and live downtown say they want to see grocery stores, mid-level dining, and places for the public to work out.
The Downtown Partnership says that the sky is the limit for how much the city can grow, but that is largely dependent upon the future administration. Tricia Pittman, Channel 11 News.
And now comes the State of Downtown report. So what positive things does it show for the city of Pittsburgh?
It shows exactly what you just mentioned, that folks are, in fact, continuing to have a renewed interest in living in the downtown area. We've had an over 20% growth in downtown residents in the last 10 years, which is just fantastic. Since 2010 alone, we've added 600 new apartments in downtown. Vacancy rates are almost non-existent. All these units are filling up really quickly, and it really is helping to make a more vibrant downtown Pittsburgh.
Are these rental units, or are these people actually buying and saying, I want to commit to living here for several years?
A lot of these are rental units that are coming in the market now. I think that speaks to just the financial markets in general. It's much easier to build apartment units at this time. But we are having a lot of interest and renewed interest in the condo markets. We saw, I believe it was over 60 units sell last year from a condo perspective. But we love seeing kind of young folks coming in, and a lot of those folks are renters. And that really is providing this real sense of vibrancy on the street level on nights and weekends, which is something that's really important to us. I think the overall perception of downtown is kind of rolling up the sidewalks and closing its doors at 5 p.m. is now becoming a misconception, and that's in fact due in large part to our growing residential community and our vibrant restaurant retail community, as well as a fantastic cultural scene in downtown.
Yeah, I mean, 10 years ago, you wouldn't come downtown after 5 p.m. Forget it. There was nothing to do.
Right.
So talk about some of the additions to the area that have helped bring in residents.
Well, I think first and foremost, the revitalization of Market Square was a big kickstart for the downtown environment. That coming online about 3 years ago, you really saw a renewed interest in restaurants being located in the square, and it has paid off tremendously. I've been in Pittsburgh for almost 2 years now, have seen over 25 restaurants open in downtown Pittsburgh since I've been here, which is pretty fantastic. But that's not just alone in Market Square. We're seeing that throughout the cultural district. You're starting to see that along Smithfield Street, just a really renewed interest in businesses thinking about expanding into their second or third location in downtown Pittsburgh, which 5-7 years ago, you wouldn't have thought of that. People were looking at more of the suburban areas, more of the commercial districts around the city, and not really considering downtown as a location.
Pittsburgh, the city had financial problems, huge financial problems, and meaning more business, more residents, that's going to lead to additional tax dollars.
Sure.
So how is this resurgence helping in the long run?
Well, it is kind of that snowball effect. You have more people investing in downtown, bringing in more jobs. You have more people kind of listening to the accolades around the country. It was one of the things that drew me here. Pittsburgh has such a great quality of life, and we have received acknowledgement from that from just about every source imaginable. And so that's continuing to draw more folks in. I think you look at our kind of low unemployment rate, the fact that we have such great institutions in Pittsburgh, from our medical institutions to our universities, really attracting more younger folks into the city. And that's playing off. These people want to live in a walkable community. They want to be able to take mass transit. We saw mass transit ridership increase by 3% last year. This was during a time when the Port Authority saw significant rate increases. So that speaks to kind of the strength of our region and the fact that, folks really value mass transit. And it's a critical component of the success of downtown.
PNC obviously has built some new buildings here recently. Why do you think they chose downtown Pittsburgh?
Well, I think we like to say we're the center of it all. We're the essential neighborhood for the region, and I think that plays into why PNC continues to want to be a major player in downtown Pittsburgh. Their new office redevelopment, building the greenest skyscraper in the world upon its completion, the redevelopment of the former Lord & Taylor space that they're converting back to a bank use, and really anchoring the redevelopment of Mellon Square is a key component to our revitalization strategy for downtown, and we really appreciate their support, along with a whole host of other corporate stakeholders who are doubling down on downtown Pittsburgh. It's such a beautiful place to be. It's extremely walkable. It's got all the major cultural and entertainment destinations for the region are all housed within just a few miles of where we're sitting right now. So it really is the place for corporate headquarters to be.
What were some of the key issues that you'll be discussing with this report?
Sure. Well, I think we continue to see a tightening of the Class A office market, which is great, but that's also going to make rents continue to increase. You couple that with a Class B office market that's seen a number of residential conversions occur, and you know, we're thinking about where can we continue to see growth in the downtown area, and that really brings us to the fringe of downtown. You look at the near strip, the lower hill, uptown, and then over on the North Shore. Those are all real opportunities for us to see continued growth and development, and those will really take the leadership of our next mayor, so whomever's selected by the City of Pittsburgh residents will really have to play a key role in working with the private sector to see these key developments come online. So that's something that we're really paying close attention to. We really want to make sure that we have a leader in place that sees this as a priority for the region.
Define Class A and Class B.
Class A space is basically your higher end, kind of full amenity, full service buildings. Class B space is slightly lower in price point and building amenities, maybe slower elevator service, older building stock in place. We have some beautiful Class A and Class B structures in downtown Pittsburgh, which continues to make us a key destination for folks looking for office space. We have about 50% of the commercial real estate office market is housed in downtown Pittsburgh, which is really not seen in any other kind of peer city of ours. You'll see a lot more development in the suburban markets, but we're really lucky here that that's all kind of concentrated here. It makes for our extremely strong public transit system as a result of that, because you do have so many people coming in and out of town on a daily basis on mass transit.
Sorry, I got lots of questions, but you know, we talk about, could Pittsburgh ever host an Olympics? Could Pittsburgh ever do this? What does it take to put Pittsburgh on that level with the bigger cities?
Well, I think, you know, the Olympics would be a really ambitious move for us. I think we have a lot of kind of complications with respect to our geography and the fact that we just don't have a lot of space to build that would really need to be thought through before making that a viable option. But I do think that we are continuing to be on the radar of many, many folks who are looking for a high quality of life. We have excellent schools here throughout the region. Again, our public transit's a key component of that. We have such great neighborhoods. Driving around the city, you know, you're just blown away by how many great commercial corridors there are servicing these beautiful old neighborhoods that Pittsburgh really offers that, many cities our size cannot compete with. So I think those are all key components that are going to continue to drive the growth and redevelopment of our city. As long as we can continue to see an increase in jobs kind of corresponding with this increase in demand, I think the sky's the limit for our city.
One last question. How much can Pittsburgh grow until we see elevated crime, too many people clogging the streets. And, you know, I look at big cities like New York and they just seem dirty. You know, how much can we grow till we reach that point where we're just not a desirable place?
Sure. I think, you know, as long as we have smart leadership who are investing in the right resources, we won't have that issue here. Our organization is committed to making downtown a cleaner and safer place. That's why we were formed over 16 years ago, really with that mission. We've annually remove about 1 million pounds of garbage from downtown Pittsburgh. So that's something that we're going to continue to do. And you have groups like ours around the city who are also doing those types of works. I think from a perspective of how much more can we grow, I think the sky's the limit when you look at these key development opportunities. But as Pittsburgh's known for, kind of slow and steady wins the race. I think that's something that we have a very prudent corporate and government leadership in play, so that we're not going to make these irrational decisions that kind of allow us to grow too quickly and expand too quickly, where that could really be to the detriment of our real estate markets. One key component is we saw an increase of 11% in building permits issued in 2012 versus 2011, and a lot of those are smaller buildings that are getting kind of renewed interest from an investment perspective, which is kind of building on our interest in seeing kind of the infill project. So we have these key marquee projects with PNC's new tower, but then you also have these smaller projects that are kind of off the radar of folks. But when you're walking down the street and you're like, oh, there's a vacancy there, like you're gonna start seeing less and less of that. It's gonna be you know, these smaller projects that are getting redeveloped, and maybe ground floor retail and then upper floor residential, which is great for us.